The Public Accounts Committee discovered with concern the low uptake of bilateral scholarships granted to the government of Uganda. Although the government of Uganda was offered 280 scholarships in the previous 3 years, only 162 were taken, leaving 118 scholarships unabsorbed, which angered MPs.
Yes, surely up to over 282 scholarships were secured in respect to the financial year we're going through, but only 165 or so were successfully absorbed, which means that most of the scholarships that are sourced from countries of goodwill, development partners, through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and directly supervised by Ministry of Education are many, but it is disappointing to note that we are not able to take up all those opportunities.
However, the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Education, Katie Lamaro, explained that some scholarships are not fully sponsored by the donors, which makes them so expensive to the beneficiaries.
Reasons why these scholarships are not fully taken, and we also indicated this. Some of the reasons are that some of these scholarships are partial. They are not full scholarships. Yeah, so I look at the cost and the benefit, of course. If you are giving me a scholarship and you're not giving me the accommodation, you're not giving me the air ticket.
Uganda receives scholarships through various schemes from the several countries through bilateral cooperation and through multilateral cooperation and direct offers to individuals through embassies of awarding governments, institutions and agencies. But legislators faulted the government for failure to provide counterfunding in cases of partial scholarships.
We are disappointed with that because we believe that for a country to offer you scholarships of a number that our people highly desire here, it should also make us move very fast such that we don't lose this chance but get our people to go and study, especially very critical skills that this country needs to benefit from for purposes of development and also benefiting us in the near future.
Committee members were shocked to learn that there is no clear policy used by the Ministry of Education to manage bilateral scholarships.
The implication is that things, it is done in a haphazard manner. Because if you have no guidelines, you have no policy, then you do according to the will and whims of particular individuals. And that's not a proper way of running ministries or running government. Yeah, we had wanted Mrs. Museveni to come here and explain to us why, after those many years in cabinet, particularly in this ministry, her ministry does not have a policy running such critical facilities.
Because there is no policy that's supposed to help us to guide or streamline these scholarships on how who should qualify and who should not qualify.
So far, of course, in absence of a law and a policy, we come up with our own guidelines, administrative guidelines, and they have been working so far.
The Ministry of Education and Sports assured the Public Accounts Committee the policy to address gaps in the scholarships has been drafted pending cabinet approval.
Policy that is going to address all those issues of scholarship management, handing, how do you fund, how do you select, how do you, you know, identify. And we are now at a point where we are moving towards cabinet approval.
It has revealed plans to form a new apex body to oversee research grants in public universities across the country following concerns of delays to execute research projects. This body will be in charge of strategic planning for universities and other institutions of higher learning.
This body will be in charge of strategic planning for universities and other institutions of higher learning. The policy has been approved by the Ministry's top management and is pending presentation to Cabinet.
This was after the audit noted significant delays in the completion of research projects. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.